So in that sense, I am absolutely a nationalist, and I'm proud of it.
Joining us now, former White House Communications Director Anthony Scaramucci. His new book is titled Trump, the Blue Collar President. I'm holding it right here in my hands. Anthony, thank you so much for being here. We're so glad you could make it.
I was thinking of the way he decorates his apartment at Trump Tower when I titled the book.
Yeah, blue collar.
Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, I thought that you guys would like
it. Yeah, gold lame president, maybe, yeah. Instead of blue collar president.
No, I mean, it's less about how he grew up, and it's more about why the people I grew up with happen to like him.
All right. Anthony Scaramucci, are you a nationalist?
No, I'm not a nationalist. No, he's not a nationalist. I mean, he's saying that he's a nationalist because he wants you to be upset about it, but he's really not a nationalist. I mean, if you really understand the historical word nationalism and you understand what it really means over the last 150 years, and we're about to go into a Veterans Day, which is the 100th year since the end of the First World War. I mean, it's just ridiculous. He's not a nationalist. And if he wants to keep saying it to upset people, and what he'll probably do is double or triple down on it, that's fine. But somebody should go and, you know, knock on the door at the Oval Office and say, hey, you're really not a nationalist. And when you say that you're a nationalist, what ends up happening is you're going to tune out some of the people that you really need. And he doesn't need to do that. And so he's got a great base of people. He's got a great economic track record to run on. He's done some very interesting things on the national security side as it relates to our footprint. I understand that he wants to put American working class families first, and he wants to put middle class families first. And so he's conflating the word nationalism for that and for those principles and policies. But if you really understand the historical context of what it means to call yourself a nationalist, you're actually not a nationalist. Stop saying it.
You don't think he understands the historical context?
No, I think he does. I think one of the strategies that the president has had that's worked very effectively is to literally push people in the intellectual elite category of our society who have really read a lot of history about the word nationalism and would caution people at an international. The Woodrow Wilson Center would caution people. The Fletcher School of Law and Diplomacy would caution people in using that word. And so he likes riling up intellectual elites.
You're a self-proclaimed blue collar kid from Long Island, right? And it bugs you. So
really.
Let's leave Fletcher and Woodrow Wilson out of this.
Not really self-proclaimed. Like, you know, like my life just happened to happen to me, right?
But my point is, this isn't an elite thing. This isn't he's upsetting the elite thing. He's upsetting you, Anthony Scaramucci. You don't like it. Admit, you don't like that he uses the word.
I've had this weird, very improbable life, though. Like, the neighborhood I grew up in, nobody went to college, right? And so I ended up going to Tufts and Harvard Law School. I ended up doing probably a lot more reading than the average person in my neighborhood. The average people in my neighborhood actually like it. Okay, so like, you
they
know, my cousin,
they like that he says
they
he's
do like Mike. Yeah, because they hear it the way he's saying it to them. What he's saying is, I'm here for you. I'm here to try to help you get your wages up. I'm here for your family. I'm here to right size these trade deals. You know, you got a raw deal from the intellectual elites that don't like the word nationalism. You got a raw deal from them. And so I'm here for you, and I'm going to raise your wages, and I'm going to right size this situation for your family. And so they love him. And he can tell 4,000 lies, or I don't know, what is he up to, 10,000 lies? I don't know. It doesn't matter to those people.
Doesn't matter to you?
Oh, absolutely. It absolutely matters to me. But see, I'm a little bit different. I thought the reason why I wrote that book is that I think I have an interesting voice here, is that I grew up in a blue-collar neighborhood, and a lot of my cousins didn't go to college. And then I went on to do some reasonably successful, but very successful things. And I hang out with a lot of elitists. And so I'm able to look at both sides of the spectrum and try to analyze it from each angle.
There are those who suggest, though, that it sounds like you're talking down to people who didn't go to the elite schools that you went to.
Let me finish.
You're talking down to them when you say, oh, these people don't care about lies. I know a lot of people from a lot of different socioeconomic backgrounds that care a lot about lying.
Okay, so let me rephrase it. They would probably, if they got an opportunity to talk to the president, they would say, hey, look, we're with you. You don't need to do the lying. You could just say what the facts are. We're with you. Some of the people, you know, were probably upset with the exaggerations and the stuff that Rick was just talking about.
Yeah.
So he doesn't really need to do it. Why is he doing it? I don't know. You'd have to ask him why he's doing it. But I'm making a different point. I'm not saying they don't care about the lies. I'm saying that the preponderance of the policies are super, super important to them. The aspects related to his personality, if you had a scale, they would take the policies, John, over the personality.
Okay, that I get.
Some of the people in, like, the salons that I've lived in since I left my home on 72 Webster Avenue, they don't like the personality, right? Even though they look at some of the policies and say, okay, those are really smart, common sense policies. The delayering of the administrative state, the deregulation, the tax policies for the United States are leading to great economic growth.
Do you think he knows he's lying?
Yeah, I think he does, yeah.
So the reason I asked...
I think he likes it, actually.
He likes lying.
Yeah, I think he likes it because I think he likes the fact that people are talking about it, and he likes the fact that it's like taking my finger and like putting in one of the two eyes that you like on your face.
Whose eyes is he putting the finger in? Because that's the part of it that I don't get. If he likes lying, what would you call someone who likes lying?
You know, like a rascal, like a scoundrel. You know, like a...
President's a scoundrel.
It's a smirk. There's a smirk on his face when he's doing it. I mean, there's also an entertainment aspect to it. You know, when he goes to a rally like that, mm-hmm. you know, there's a level of embellishment there because he's playing to the crowd. He's playing for the laughs, and he... You know, I mean, that's been his persona. That's been his style. And by the way, you can't really argue with the success of it. You have to look at what he's done in his life.
The success of
it
is a different story.
Tremendously successful.
Again, I asked you, what do you call someone who likes to lie? You say a scoundrel. Another thing you could call someone who likes to lie is a liar. Is he a liar?
Okay, well, we both know that he's telling lies, okay? So if you want me to say he's a liar, I'm happy to say he's a liar. But I'm telling you mm-hmm. that... Those people that I wrote about in that book yeah. and the research that I did on it, on the levels of the weighted average of what they really care about, they care way less about that, John, and they care way more about, okay, we finally have a president that's my advocate. And so all of that other nonsense that he does, that existential nonsense, mm-hmm. is less important to them.
That may be. I just don't like, and I think you and I agree on, I don't like when people say, oh, because someone didn't go to college, they don't care about lying. Because I know for a fact that people do care about lying. Your book, The Blue Collar President, I know you explain
rephrase
yourself.
Okay, good. Let me rephrase it because I think it's super important for everybody to understand. Nobody should lie. I'm not a big believer in lying, but politicians happen
to
lie.
You want to say that to the camera, to the president?
Nobody should lie.
Mr. President?
But, you know, you're a politician now, so politicians lie when their lips are moving, and so all these people lie. But you should probably dial down the line because you don't need to. You're doing a great job for the country. So dial that down and you'll be doing a lot better. You know, if you don't want to be stuck in the mid-40s going into the 2020 reelection.
One of the things, the reasons that I'm glad you wrote this book the way you did, I do think that one of the things that's fascinating is that Donald J. Trump.